there a question there?
Perhaps we can get down to the bottom of this then.
Can I ask a question, real quick question? When you subpoenaed Dr. Collati, did you pay him a witness fee?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Do you know if he's here?
No, Your Honor. He is not here. I don't see him so far. So was the school district...
See, that's another reason why you need a lawyer to tell you what you can do now, if he doesn't show up. And I can't tell you, because it's legal advice.
Your Honor, the Discovery Commission, I believe, is who handles that. And
actually, no. I handle the failure of a witness to appear upon proper service of a subpoena, including the requisite witnessing. I handle it. But I don't know enough, and that's where I wish you had an attorney to help you.
Your Honor, sit down.
Sir, the only person who can tell Mr. Grimes to sit down is me. Mr. Grimes, sit down.
Thank you, Your Honor. Dr. Collati is supposed to be here. So are the teachers from Lewis E. Roy Elementary. They were ordered by the Discovery Commissioner to be here.
I don't know that... Here's another problem. The Discovery Commissioner cannot issue an order. The Discovery Commissioner can write a report and recommendation, which then has to wait for the end of an... I'm merely stating the law now. Which then has to wait for an objection period. If there is no objection, it is then submitted to me to make it an order. I have not yet signed an order that would make the recommendations by Commissioner Truman an actual order.
Okay. Your Honor?
Again, if you had an attorney to help you, that particular individual could, in fact, explain that to you.
Your Honor, I've had several run-ins with the school district for their refusal to give me my own son's records. And they still, as of yet, even with the recommendations that they've received from the Discovery Commission, have refused to give me the records that I require.
You know, I looked at the minutes of your hearing with the Discovery, with the Discovery Hearing Master, they're called now.
Yes, Your Honor.
And frankly, Mr. Hall, I understood there was an agreement by the attorney for the school district to provide you with certain documents. If that didn't happen, I don't know. I do know that in the course of the minutes, it looks like there had been some agreement with you represented, but I haven't seen a stipulation in order, nor have I seen any kind of
they have acted in bad faith, Your Honor, and have not provided the documents, even though they claimed
and you're back in front of, and here's the problem, you're back in front of Hearing Master Truman on March 27th because you did file a motion. You did file a motion. I see it. You filed it last week.
Yes, Your Honor. I did.
Okay, but it's not in front of me today.
Oh.
It's in front of Hearing Master Truman on March 27th at 1:30. I'm looking at the record.
Yes, Your Honor.
So I can do nothing on that issue right now.
Yes, Your Honor.
It has to go through the normal processes. Mr. Grimes, why are you standing up?
Only because I'd like to save the time of the court and Commissioner Truman. His issue is bad faith. They didn't give him an unredacted copy of the pickup sheet. The minutes of the second hearing that was held made very clear that the information that he wanted that was redacted, she will testify to upon a question. And we, on the record, stated who it was that was redacted. That's what the bad faith motion is about. He cleared up with one question.
Why don't you ask the question? Go ahead. Ask the question you want to ask.
Your Honor, that's not the issue. The issue is this. I am the father of Storm and Emmanuel Hall.
You're the father of what?
Storm and Emmanuel and
we know
Israel.
That.
I believe in my heart of hearts that I am responsible to every drop and ounce of information that those kids have in that school district that's public.
But see, here's the problem. You are very much entitled to that information, probably, but I'm not sure I am or the record is. In other words, a document that you might be able to get full access to, you're entitled to have joint legal custody of those two boys, but they might not come into the record with all the information you want on the record. The school district made the decision, apparently, according to Mr. Grimes, to redact some information, okay? To take it out. That doesn't mean you're not entitled to access. The question is whether or not, ironically, I am.
Your Honor, that is a misstatement, a misnomer by the counsel here. I even wanted a redacted copy. I'll take a redacted copy.
You have gotten no copy.
I've gotten no copy.
Okay. And that's the problem. The problem is it's not...
Sorry about that, Your Honor.
Please turn your phone off.
My phone was turned on by the IT guy who were trying to get this up, and that's why he needed it out. I just turned it off.
So, given that you don't have the information, and again, that's right now in front of the Discovery Commissioner, unfortunately, and I have no personal information or even secondhand information as to who of your witnesses should be here and why they're not here. I don't know. If you've properly served a subpoena, then I would have expected these individuals, if they didn't want to appear, to move for a protective order. I don't know what happened.
Your Honor, I have problems.
There are many reasons why I don't know. Judges aren't supposed to know things. You know? When we sit as a trier of fact, we sit in a way as a jury, in the sense that we too cannot just take everything that comes in. It has to be properly admitted for me to look at. It needs to be supported by our rules of evidence for me to look at it. In that sense, I'm kind of like a jury who doesn't get everything.
Your Honor, I have this certificate.
I'll tell you, one of the biggest complaints juries have is they know there's a piece missing. That's one of the biggest gripes. They know there's something missing that might tie something together. Guess what? Judges like me have the same problem because we can't get everything.
Your Honor, I have subpoenas, and I have they've been filed, and
what?
I have copies of the subpoenas that have been filed.
You know,
and have been served along.
But
with
I don't have proof of payment of the witness fee. Ironically,
along with the payment of the witness fee, I have the copy of the money orders that were purchased and delivered with the subpoenas.
Your Honor, at this point, I'm going to object. He's sitting here just doing administrative stuff. There's a witness on the stand. He needs to either complete his cross-examination or his examination and rest his case or call his next witness.
Mr. Grimes, it's not my job to do Mr. Paul's job, okay? Nor can I give him a great deal of leeway to do something that an attorney cannot do. However, your client is advantaged by having you here. He is confused, and again, I say that with respect, sir, but you are confused, and it is confusing. He's trying to get to something and isn't getting there, but I'm going to give him just a little opportunity before you get up and tell him when he has to start asking questions. I'll tell him when he has to move on, sir, so please sit down.
Your Honor,
I said please sit down, didn't
okay.
I? Now you can talk seated, but you don't need to stand up.
Well, my issue, Your Honor, I frankly tried to address the issue of Dr. Collati. He's issued a subpoena. We have filed an objection to his being called. His attorney is awaiting my text message to notify whether or not he needs to be here. I thought maybe he'd like to know that, but instead he told me to sit down. So I will sit down.
Well, now that raises a point. Do we have a witness that's not here because you told them not to show up?
Absolutely not.
Okay, then bring him here.
Okay.
I actually want to hear from Dr. Collati.
Well, and I'm still going to object. He wasn't disclosed as a witness. He certainly wasn't disclosed.
You mean the motion on an order shortening time that was never properly served on the defendant?
Are we okay, Your Honor?
Please sit down. If Dr. Collati has been duly subpoenaed, at a minimum, he's obligated to appear. Now, whether he ends up testifying, it becomes another question. But an attorney cannot tell a witness not to appear.
Your Honor, I didn't. I would never do such a thing.
Okay.
I was simply asked.
I misunderstood what you said then.
No. From his lawyer, I was asked to text her if the court ruled on this issue. And I'm texting right now that the court wants him here.
I do want him here.
Okay.
You know why I want him here? Because there's a lot of concern on this issue of the medical treatment being administered to Emmanuel. Okay? It would help me determine what's in the best interest of Emmanuel, as well as Storm, to get some insight as to any medical treatment they've received, and that includes psychological treatment. Okay? I want to do the right thing. Okay? I want to do the right thing by these boys.
Then I should have had it disclosed in time for me to get a rebuttal witness to discuss whatever's going on. I don't even know what he's going to testify to. It's inappropriate. It violates the rules.
So why did you wait until Wednesday to provide me with your motion for an order shortening time on this very important issue, the motion in limine? Again, I got it.
The order shortening time, Your Honor, sat down here for a week. It was delivered the very day we filed the request for an OST. We got it back on Wednesday. Mr. Hall was in my office on Thursday, agreed that he would take my call and provide service. I have it on video. He's now sitting here saying and refused service all day Thursday and all day Friday so the motion in limine could not be heard. So I'm simply waiting for him to call the witness and I'll object at that time.
Let me ask a simple question. Sounds like we're going to have a third day of trial, because I will give you, Mr. Grimes, the opportunity to bring in a rebuttal witness if you need to, but doesn't it make sense if one of the people whose names keep coming up again and again and again tells me who, what, why, and where, and helps me at the end of the day figure out what's in the best interest of two minor children? That's all I want to do.
Okay. All I know is that rules apply.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
And discovery closed.
Motions in limine, and as well as any motion to exclude evidence, is still to the discretion of the trier of fact.
Agreed.
It's my discretion. Now, if in fact Mr. Hall can demonstrate that notwithstanding his failure to follow the rules, it is of benefit to the trier in fact to hear from a particular witness who should have been disclosed but wasn't, then I have to ask, do I exercise my discretion to exclude it so I am dumber than I already am? Or do I hear from this witness so that I can be a little smarter than I already am?
And again, I think the court's as well versed as I am is in the conflicting rules that come out of the Supreme Court, where they say if discovery's not followed, it's excluded, and yet where children are involved,
we exactly, don't. Exactly. Which is why I'm doing exactly what the Supreme Court is telling me to do. They say, and I agree with you, by the way, every time we see one of these cases where somebody has totally blown the discovery rules and the judge has acted improperly applying the rules to the letter, gets sent back down. Well, it's overriding that we look at the best interests of minor children. You're right. And that's why I'm taking this position, exactly because the Supreme Court said we have to temper the rules. I don't say that's right. You know me, rules judge and all. But one thing I've learned over the years, especially with the current composition of the Supreme Court, is that if blindly following exclusionary rules, the judge does not have sufficient information to determine what's in the best interest of the minor child, then the judge has the discretion to say, you're right, but, and that's where we are today.
Your Honor, what I would ask you is if you're going to permit him to call Dr. Kaladi, and for the record, I've texted his attorney, whose name is Bridget Kelly, who asked me to text her and gave me the cell, that the court has requested his presence, so I'm assuming that we'll be here shortly.
Okay, and we'll take him out of order.
But before he gets to call him, because I filed the motion in limine and it was not heard at 10 o'clock this morning prior to this trial, I would like Mr. Hall on the stand regarding the service of that motion, his knowledge of the motion, and the fact that he played the games, and when he decided to call Dr. Kaladi, basically.
I think he was identified a while ago.
It was after the close of, because I objected.
He may have been identified in a pretrial memorandum that Mr. Hall filed back in July.
Okay.
He was identified. I mean, so, look, I get your frustration, counsel. And, frankly, we're always looking at the rules. But when I've got a Supreme Court that is saying to me, yeah, but. And again, my goal is always to do right by kids. If it's in my power to do right by kids, I do that. I don't want Emmanuel and Storm to be weak. I want them to be strong and powerful and successful. I know you've heard me say this, but I mean it. And if I can figure out a way that notwithstanding their parents' ill will toward each other, that they get that opportunity, I'm going to make a decision that works for them. It may not work for their parents. They may not like it, and they both may walk out of this room thinking that I'm a piece of something. But if I believe that following not only the law, but the dictates of the Supreme Court as to what I look at and what I know and what I can fashion for these boys is in their best interest, that's the route I'm going to take when all is said and done. Look, Emmanuel and Storm did not ask their parents to get a divorce. They didn't ask their parents to be at each other's throats. They didn't ask to be embarrassed at school when their parents are acting out. So now where do we go from here? Well, I'm going to try to go to give them the best of all possible worlds under the circumstances. If there's something that is not going to be pertinent to the best interest of the minor children, I'll hear your arguments on those documents. If, however, they are pertinent, they assist the court in determining what's in the best interest of two minor children, I think the Supreme Court is saying, look at it. Knowing that a party didn't follow our rules and didn't do what they were supposed to do. Knowing that. And then you are free to take me up on appeal and let the Supreme Court slap me, seriously, for doing what they want me to do.
And I hope the court understands my frustration as well. If we don't object, then they send it back and slap us and say we didn't preserve the objection.
So I want you to object. Okay? That's fair enough. I want you to preserve the record. Don't misunderstand me. I do. But at the same time, I think that if we blindly apply the rules, as much as I'm a fan of rules in an orderly courtroom, and somehow I miss something and do wrong by either or both of these children, I don't think that's what the Supreme Court wants me to do. because there's been decision after decision now saying, yeah, but. And we know that. And we all look and go, what? Okay, so the rules of evidence maybe don't apply in the family division of the district court. And apparently they don't apply blindly when it comes to kids. So I have to acknowledge that. Okay? All right, sir. We are back to school records that you want to ask the plaintiff about.
Yes,
see, I didn't forget.
Can I make a comment?
No, there's nothing to comment, sir. You know what? I just ruled
She's
in your
right
favor
about a couple of things,
on
Your Honor,
Ms. Dr. Collette. You
back.
Don't need to respond. You don't need to attack Mr. Grimes. Let's just move on.
Your Honor, he's right about a couple of things. He's right. My brother just passed away this week. My brother lives here in Las Vegas. His name is Vincent Leon Hall. I have been just inundated with the family and dealing with his thing, so I couldn't get back to him. So he's right, I didn't get back to him. He's absolutely right about that.
Okay.
I
sorry about your brother, but now move on, please.
You bet, Your Honor. Why? You just said that you didn't feel it was necessary to give Dr. Pilati the collateral information that he needed to be able to make a better decision, such as the information from HBI that shows that the kids don't act out when they're in my care.
Dr. Claudi is a psychiatrist.
I wasn't finished with the question. And
except it includes an awful lot of testimony.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to ask it the right way without trying to cause trouble. And also from Dr. Habibi over at St. Rose Pediatrics. Was there a reason that you didn't give them the pertinent information that the kids don't act out at all when they're in my care?
I don't remember actually saying anything. He gave me a bunch of forms to fill out. He gave the teachers a bunch of forms to fill out, and he observed him in the office.
He was
referred. He knew the primary care doctor because the primary care doctor had to do a referral.
He wasn't referred by Dr. Habibi.
Well, he was referred
Objection,
by...
Objection, he's now testifying.
I'm sorry.
He referred by St. Rose Pediatrics. Our children doesn't have one pediatrician. Our children are seen by St. Rose Pediatrics, and whoever is on call that day or has available appointments, they see him.
Who was the person that they actually made the referral?
I don't remember.
You don't remember?
I don't remember.
Okay.
St. Rose Pediatrics sent the referral. Their referral department sent the referral to...
Who did you see to get the referral?
We made an appointment. I don't remember which... We see a different doctor every time we go in. Sometimes it's a nurse practitioner, sometimes it's the pediatrician.
Was it the nurse practitioner?
I don't know. This was well over a year ago.
Well, then, if it was well over a year ago, can you explain why I haven't received knowledge?
I tell you, every text message of every appointment that they have.
Can you produce those text messages that shows me when you told me that Dr. Collati was taking care of the kids? Can you produce that text message?
Not right now, not without prior.
Okay, we'll bring you up to the stand later and you can show us.
I don't even know what phone it's on. I don't know if it's on this.
Objection. I mean, besides badgering.
You can't instruct a witness on what they have to do, only I can.
Oh, okay. Sorry about that, Your Honor. Do you remember an incident over at 5400 West Cheyenne where Storm was jumping into the pool and actually hit his head on the concrete on the way into the water?
Yes.
Were you in the pool at that time?
No, because Emmanuel was not in the pool. I was in the pool, and I was in the pool when Israel died because I thought that's where I needed to be with our son, Storm. So when I have one child outside the pool, I am outside the pool, so I can go into any direction after a kid. When you're inside a pool, deep down on the ground, you can't see around. Hence, Israel died.
Can you give me a time frame, Mr. Hall? I'm surprised Mr. Grimes didn't ask for foundation.
Just give me about 10 more minutes, John.
No, sir. You said Storm jumped into a pool and hit his head. When? Where? You gave me the address, you gave me where, but when?
Do you remember when that happened?
It had to be last 2 summers ago.
Okay, so he hit his head on the pool on the way in. Do you remember an incident over at, another water incident over at Caledonia Bay? Can you elaborate on that?
What's the incident?
Sir, you gotta ask her, you gotta focus her on time.
We'll get back to that another time. You had, after Israel's passing, you had the boys for Christmas Eve and Christmas morning, is that not correct?
That's not correct, because you had rights to them. I did not.
Okay. The following Christmas, did you have the kids for Christmas night and Christmas Eve? Christmas Eve and Christmas morning.
Object, Lax Foundation. I just want a year.
In 2017, did you have the kids for Christmas night and Christmas morning?
The judge ordered that I have the boys Christmas Eve till noon on Christmas Day. And you got them Christmas Day.
2018, did you have the kids for Christmas Eve and Christmas morning?
Again, the judge had the order that I had them from Christmas Eve to noon Christmas Day.
The judge ordered it?
Yes, we actually spoke in a hearing right before Christmas, actually. And she said that there was temporary orders.
Okay. And what happened this last Christmas?
I assume that's 2018.
Yes. Thank you. What happened 2018 for Christmas?
You wanted them Christmas Eve.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know about that. Please forgive me. I wanted them for Christmas Eve.
And there was another court order where she, I'm not trying to put words in your mouth, Your Honor, I'm sorry, where she changed visitation to where you had them on weekends.
So, who did the children spend Christmas with?
Me.
And who else?
Me.
Were they with Nathan Presley?
No, actually.
Were they at Nathan Presley's sister's home?
That was Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving? So for Christmas, for Thanksgiving, I don't get to see them. They get to be with Nathan. Is Nathan Presley a convicted felon?
Objection, relevance.
It's very relevant. They're around my kids.
Overruled.
I just found out when you brought it up.
You just found out?
I don't do background checks on everybody that I'm around.
Oh, I have a witness that says otherwise. Okay, good deal. Okay, so you never knew that Nathan Presley was a convicted felon?
No, he's a high priest leader in our church and holds a temple recommend.
Okay.
Objection, that was testimonial and completely inappropriate.
Well, then the good news is I didn't hear it.
Okay, good.
Okay, so for the record, Your Honor, Nathan Presley was also served.
Sir, you can't testify. You can only ask questions. Oh, he was subpoenaed. Yes, I know he was subpoenaed.
Yes, okay.
I think you filed it. Let's see. I'll look at it again.
About 2 hours ago.
I'm sorry, what?
I filed it 2 hours ago. Sometimes I'll serve it, and I get so excited about serving it that I forget to file it because I'm not an attorney.
But when did you serve it?
I'm sorry?
When did you serve it?
He got served last week, I believe, by a guy named Jason Anderson.
Huh?
From what I understand.
talk to a lawyer who can help you figure out what you can ask me to do.
Okay. Yes, sir. Your Honor, is there any way that I can get an order to have the seven people that I have subpoenaed show up?
It's asking for legal advice.
No, I'm asking for legal advice.
You are asking for legal advice. What can I do is legal advice.
I am making a verbal motion to have the people that have not shown up today that have been served to order them to appear before the court. It will clarify a lot of things.
Mr. Grimes.
We took great detail in our motion in limine to not object to anything that had been previously disclosed. I mean, I spent a lot of time with my law clerk. Any witness that, and I was trying to pull the motion in limine up to make sure of exactly which ones we were objecting to. Other than that, he didn't call them. We objected to anyone that had not been disclosed, which includes the one he's currently talking about. I've already talked about Dr. Kaladi. We didn't object, other than we felt it was expert. You've already said. My position is all laid out in the motion in limine. If he previously disclosed it, by all means, have fun with it.
No, he was not. Mr.
I know.
President
Mr. Presley was not.
So if he doesn't show, I think you need to talk to a lawyer as to what your options are.
Your Honor,
And again, you know, we're busy in our country now looking at criminal justice anyway. And what things people get incarcerated for, what people get convicted of and everything. And I'm not here to get on a soapbox and say it's about time, but being a convicted felon doesn't tell me anything about a person's character. That narrow bit of information, there are all shapes and sizes of felonies. Some might be pertinent to the safety of children, and some might not be. And should any single parent who meets a person they don't know and don't know a lot about research somebody? Some people are more diligent than others. On the other hand, if a single parent meets somebody through their church who in fact has a couple recommend, they might be less inclined to research that person and find out what happened in 1986. So I don't know, you know, I appreciate you want to ask this individual about himself, but maybe you're better off just asking the plaintiff what she knows about this individual.
Your Honor,
And understand, and I've said this before, people make mistakes, people fix their mistakes. I know nothing about Mr. Presley other than, as you said, he was convicted of a felony sometime, somewhere, for some reason.
Your Honor.
But apparently has ingratiated himself, according to the plaintiff, with the church. Temple recommends aren't easy to get, from what I vaguely know from our community. Ask her, not me.
Your Honor, I want to state as to why my line of questioning is going where it's going.
And I don't need to know why. Just do your line of questioning.
But it directly relates to what
Sir,
you just said.
Sir, you're making your closing argument now. I don't want to hear your closing argument.
Okay.
I want you to finish examining this witness.
Yeah. Okay, how long have you known Nathan Presley?
About 2.5 years.
2.5 years. Oh, when did you first meet Nathan Presley?
At a church activity. I don't know an approximate time. It was a couple years ago.
are there rules against you associating with other convicted felons?
Objection, relevance.
Overruled.
There is, but I didn't know he was a convicted felon at the time. And I wasn't hanging around him. Our relationship was strictly the children. He was working, and I was the caregiver. I helped homeschool his oldest daughter. I took him to 4-H activities. I see the children more I do.
Do you know a lady named Anna Bartarelli?
Anna Bartarelli, yes.
Was Anna there when Israel died?
No.
Was anyone in Anna's family there when the children, when Israel
died? Two of her children.
Were you responsible for watching those children?
I was.
So you were watching Storm, Emmanuel, Israel, and you were watching, what's the two children's names?
Cole and Angelia. And
Cole
they
and
were
Angelia
13 years old and 9 years old at the time.
What's their last name?
Bartoletti.
Bartoletti. So you were watching those children at the time that Israel passed, is that correct?
As well as Elisa Walls that was at the pool as well.
Were you with Elisa Walls in close proximity when Israel passed?
I was, along with the Metro police officer that was catty corner to me.
No, I'm talking about when Israel started drowning.
Yes. We were in a triangle shape.
Triangle.
Where I have this, you know, in front of me. The Metro police officer had vision in front of her. Elisa Wall had vision in front of her. You know, we all try to help each other out. Watching all the children.
When you speak of the Metro police officer, do you know the name of this police officer?
Cam Watts.
Cam Watts.
I said this as gently as I could many, many times. Something unspeakable happened to you and the plaintiff. Okay? No, you let me finish my comment. Okay? It did. It happened. And I can't imagine the pain associated with it. And I am extremely, as much as I can be, very sympathetic to the pain it caused you. However, I'm also concerned, and more concerned, about the best interests of the surviving children. We've got to go to that. If, in fact, the plaintiff has repeated behaviors that caused or contributed to the death of your toddler, that would be relevant. The event itself isn't going to tell me that. I am not trying to be harsh with you. I've said this before. It is important that we can figure out what's in the best interest of the two children that are here and alive now. Dwelling on the past, unless the past gets repeated, doesn't assist me. Following me? You don't want to, but are you following me? So let's, since that horrible thing happened, now what? What's happened? How have you co-parented? What is in the best interest of two boys, one's 8, one's 9? I want to make the best decision for them. There's nothing I can do for the sibling they lost.
Your Honor, I am very well aware of your concerns, and I note them, and I am taking them very, very seriously. Your concerns, they are utmost in my mind. I am trying to establish a pattern of behavior.
Okay, let's get to, all right. describe, I'll let you do a little more examination on the event itself, if that will assist you in showing repeats.
Yes, it does, John.
Okay, go ahead.
There was an incident at Cowabunga Bay where Emmanuel seemed to have fallen out of the quote-unquote big boat. Do you remember this?
Can you focus her on time?
You don't remember a time?
Are you talking about the time where Emmanuel was sitting in front of me on a double raft and we went down a water slide and we hit the water and we both fell out of the raft? Emmanuel was wearing a life jacket?
Yes.
Yeah. What's the problem with that? We went down a water slide. He fell out just like probably 99% of the people go down a water slide and fall out of the raft. But he was wearing a life jacket and a lifeguard was right there.
I didn't say anything was wrong with it at all. Do you remember Emmanuel or Storm trying to find you when they were in a different pool and you were in it in a completely different area of the water park?
I wasn't in a really different area of the water park. Have you been to Cowabunga Bay?
Yes, I have.
And you know how long that water slide is?
I do.
Okay, so when I sent the two boys up with their friends, up on top of, in line, the only way I could see where they were is if I walked to the back where the entrance to the slide is. And it just happened that they were going down the slide at the same time I was looking to see where they were at in line. I had them in my eyesight the whole time.
Do you remember the kids coming up to you in tears crying?
They have been traumatized, Burke. They have been traumatized these last 3 years.
I asked a simple question.
Do you remember
them coming up to you at the end of the day when it was getting dark, crying?
It wasn't getting dark.
You're with me. How you doing?
I'm okay.
Oh, are you done?
Yeah, you're wrong. You passed the witness. I just passed it. Temporarily. Burke brought up a lot about pool incidents.
Yes.
Do you recall if the court ordered that swim lessons were to occur?
Yes.
Or did swim lessons occur?
No.
Okay. Why didn't they occur?
Because the defendant was ordered to take them. That's the whole point of visitation getting switched, and he never took them.
After the incident with your one child, how long did the two of you continue to reside together?
It was until we separated September of 2016, I moved out.
So, to be
clear, it was a little over a year.
You moved out of the Tivoli apartment, correct?
I did.
So, this incident, you were still residing with the defendant?
I was.
Which incident?
The pool incident at Tivoli that you referred to. I never did get the dates, but the pool incident at Tivoli, you
were
still residing.
Right.
Issue of therapy with Dr. Collodi.
Yes.
How long did Emmanuel see Dr. Collodi?
I believe we started seeing him it was right when the school got out last summer when Judge Pomerantz asked for a evaluation. And then whenever that email was sent when they terminated services.
Well, let's get there one thing at a time. Did you subsequently receive a letter from Dr. Collodi terminating services?
Yes.
Okay. I'm honestly not sure if this one's already been admitted, Your Honor. Has 43 been admitted?
No.
Okay. I'm going to ask you to look at proposed Exhibit 43.
Yes.
permission to approach.
Your Honor, may I approach the witness?
Yeah, go ahead.
I place before you a letter from Dr. Pilati, marked Proposed Exhibit 43. Is that the letter you received?
Yes.
Okay. Has it been altered in any way?
No.
Okay. And again, I'm not going to ask for its admission at this point because Dr. Pilati is going to be called later, so I'll simply do it through him. But based on your understanding and what you were told by the doctor and nothing else, what's your understanding of why services were terminated?
Because is there a reason why it's not being admitted now?
I figure if I've got the author of the letter coming.
Why don't we do double duty here?
Okay.
Excuse me, Your Honor.
Moot.
Excuse me. 43 was admitted. It was admitted on December 28th.
Okay.
Oh, it's already been admitted.
So it's already admitted. All right.
Okay, thank you.
So what's your understanding of why services were terminated?
Dad went in and started making threats to the provider. And due to the provider not wanting to get involved in a custody case, he just decided to not treat the patient.
Okay. And is Manuel getting any services at this time as a result?
He just sees not a psychiatrist, just a therapist.
Let's talk about something a little more.
Can we, just for the record, give me an opportunity to take a look at it again. Go ahead.
Let's talk about events that are a little more current. The last time we were here, do you recall a discussion with the court regarding a 4-H event?
Yes.
Okay. What was your understanding of the order that day?
That the boys were to attend the livestock show, and Dad would either take them or switch weekends with me.
Okay. To your knowledge, did Dad take them?
No.
Did the children attend the 4-H show?
No.
Do you have personal knowledge of where they were that weekend?
In California.
Did you offer to switch weekends?
I did.
Was it ever agreed you would switch weekends?
No.
Okay. Were you at any time told why the children were not attending the 4-H show?
Can you give me some foundation counsel?
What was it, the second week in January?
It was January, yes, or I have to look at my calendar.
Well, it,
it was in January. It was
what year?
2018, or 19.
It was the last weekend of, it was actually, because I have them the third weekend, so it was the fourth weekend of the show.
Okay, so fourth weekend of January, 2019, the children did not attend the 4-H show.
Correct.
Do you currently have an order regarding the exchange of children?
Yes.
Where is the exchange supposed to occur?
At Metro Police Department, if the children are not in school.
Okay. On Friday, were the kids in school?
No.
Did you exchange the children with Mr. Hall?
Not at the police station.
Just
no.
Question.
Well, yes.
Did
yes,
you exchange
yes,
the children?
Yes.
Where did that exchange take place?
At my house.
Was Mr. Hall invited to your home?
No.
Did you know he was coming?
No.
What time does your order say the exchange is to occur?
3 o'clock, if not in school.
And what time did the exchange occur?
Around 1 o'clock.
Can you explain to the court exactly how that exchange occurred?
There was a knock at my door, so I opened my door. He forced himself into my door, standing in the doorway, wouldn't allow me to shut the door, and demanded that the kids come with them. Emmanuel, we were home, so Emmanuel was in his underwear. Storm was wearing clothes that he wore the day before, because it was a snow day, we stayed home, and he demanded that they come. I insisted that Emmanuel at least put some clothes on. He took the kids with no shoes, no socks, no jacket, and just took them.
Okay. And the exchange back, on Sunday. Did that occur?
Yes, at the police station.
That occurred at Metro?
Yes.
So, did it occur at the correct time?
Yes.
Did they have shoes on at that point?
No.
Still no shoes?
No.
The approximate date of the Calabunga Bay event that is being described by Mr. Hall?
We went on Calabunga Bay every year. Does the you get 3 A's on your report card, you go for free, so it was one of those days.
Okay.
We actually went, I think, twice.
All right. Did you ever not know where your children were?
I knew where my children are all the time.
Okay. Was there ever a time where they lost sight of you?
Yes, just like every other child.
Okay. Do you know what slide they were on at the time that this event occurred?
I don't know the exact name, but it was the big old slip and slide that has no pull at the end. And they lay down on the ramp and they go head first down. It's the different colored ones. That stems like half the park.
All right. And where were you?
I was at the exit, but it was a long line. So I wanted to see where they were at in line. So I walked towards the back to look up to see where they were.
Okay.
And that's when they were coming down.
And did you ever lose sight of them?
No.
Okay. So you knew where they were?
Yes.
We have been hearing a lot about slashing tires. Do you recall that information?
I recall the information. It's not true.
Have you ever slashed Mr. Hall's tires?
I've never slashed any tire.
Mr. Hall brings up the fact that there was issues with visitation in late 2018. Okay. Do you recall there being a period of time where Mr. Hall did not have visitation?
Yes.
Okay. What was the reason there was no visitation?
He didn't show up.
Was there any other reasons for no visitation?
Just because he didn't show up.
Okay. At present, do you have his address?
No.
Do you know where he resides?
No.
What address do you have?
A P.O. box. Well, it's a Tropicana. Not a P.O. box, but it's one of the mail centers.
Do you have reason to believe that he's not residing at that address?
Well,
I'm sorry, what was the question?
Whether or not she has reason to believe he is not residing at the address given.
It's a mail address, so he can't reside there.
Okay. Have you been given any other locations where your children are residing?
No, I just know what the kids tell me.
Now, I want to cover this because we actually said we would do it at the discovery motion. Okay? There was a exchange or a pickup list provided and filled out by you at the school.
Yes.
Okay. Is your name on that?
Not
as a parent?
As a parent, yes.
Okay. Is Mr. Hall, to your knowledge, on that as a parent?
Yes.
Okay. Was there a time that you placed someone else on that as an authorized pickup for your children?
Yes.
Children? And who was that?
Nathan Presley, Christina Leverton, I believe Stacy is on it, that's sitting here, Vicki Fransman, and I have their PSRBST worker that works under the therapist.
Okay. Why did you have these people listed?
Because things happen. I'm at the VA a lot, and sometimes if I'm stuck in traffic or unforeseen accident happens, you're supposed to have people on a list to get to your kids if in an emergency you can't.
Okay. Did you tell Mr. Hall who you had as your emergency pickups?
No.
Okay. To your knowledge, did Mr. Hall have any emergency pickups?
I'm sorry, what?
To her knowledge, did she know if Mr. Hall had any emergency pickups listed.
I don't know, because we're not, the school doesn't tell us any information on the other party.
Okay. Has he ever informed you of who his emergency pickups
no.
are? Have you ever asked?
No.
Let me ask a few questions first. Okay, Storm is 9.
Yes.
Manuel's 8.
Yes.
Does either child know how to swim?
Storm knows how to swim, and we attempted. Emmanuel started swimming last summer. I'm not comfortable with him in the pool alone.
Okay, but Storm, you're comfortable with him in
yes.
the pool?
Yes. He does flips. Jumps into the pool.
How did he learn how to swim?
We live at the pool every summer. I mean, he knew how to swim when Israel died. When you're in the pool every day in the summer, you just, I mean.
Does either child have a fear of water?
Emmanuel has a little bit. And, Your Honor, can I say something?
No, because there's no question pending.
Oh. Regarding swim lessons.
What?
I wanted to say something regarding swim lessons.
You already explained it. Okay. Both boys just finished a semester at CATS, right?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, did you get their semester grades?
Yes, it's in the exhibits.
As best you can recall, without having the document in front of you, what were Storm's grades?
He has 8 in B honor roll.
8 in B honor roll.
Yes.
And how about Emmanuel?
Emmanuel, he struggles in reading and writing, and other than that, he has A's, B's, and C's.
Okay. And both children are going to go on to the next semester?
Well, Emmanuel's kind of iffy because of the read by three law. Because of the read-by-three law, I'm kind of in a dilemma because I requested a neuropsychological evaluation for educational issues, and every time I try to get one, Dad refuses. So without that knowledge, the school can't really help him, and because he reads 9 words a minute and he's supposed to be at almost 100, he might be held back. But I can't get him services because we both have legal custody, and every time I try to get him help, it gets stopped.
Does Emmanuel want help?
I don't know. At this point, he's just frustrated. He hates being called, you know, he feels that he's a failure because he can't read like everybody else, and it's a struggle for him. And the PSR, he gets PSR and BST from the therapist.
What are those?
It's basic, they come to the home or take him out in public and work on skills. And right now it's pretty, his impulsivity. And teach him techniques to stay calm. Because right now, well, I want to say right now it's getting a little better, but in the past he would get so overwhelmed that he would just melt down.
Your Honor.
So is he aware of his deficit in reading?
He is.
Okay. Do you have either boy in any extracurricular activities?
Yes, they're both in 4-H and they do scouts through church.
Okay. Nothing necessarily associated with the school?
No, Emmanuel or Storm wanted to try out for the basketball team. But Dad wouldn't allow it because the games would be on his time.
Okay, your answer, what?
Your Honor, that was much of my case in chief. I didn't go there because one of us didn't waive scope. So I didn't want you believing that I had simply ignored.
No, 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 no.
Okay.
That, Okay. I wanted to know.
Who taught Storm Anthony Hall how to swim?
What?
He kind of learned on his own. I was in the pool with them almost every day in the summer except for Sundays.
So I did not teach him how to swim.
How could you when you were on the road every 2 weeks, every other week? You were never around.
Wow. So you just testified that you were not, you've never been aware of who was picking up Storm and Emmanuel on
no.
my side of the fence.
No.
But yet, when you were in court, you vehemently objected to Mari being on the pickup list.
Yes, because you listed her. I didn't know she was on the pickup list. You listed her as the legal guardian on the safe key application, and I went to pick up my son, and the safe key wouldn't release her to me, release the boys to me, because she was listed as a legal guardian, and I wasn't listed at all. That's why she was taken off of the pickup list.
Okay. How involved would you say I am with Katz Elementary?
Objection beyond the scope.
I wouldn't know.
Yeah, I'm gonna allow the question.
So who informed you, if it wasn't me that informed you, that I didn't want Emmanuel to go to get special services or special reading services, who informed you that I was the one stopping it?
I didn't say it was the school. I said it was the I was trying to get a referral to a neuropsychologist, in which you went to St. Rose Pediatrics and created a ruckus. And we just decided to...
Define ruckus.
Well, you claimed that he only has the problem in my care. You claim he is perfectly fine in your care.
Are you aware of any letters from Dr. Habibi or from Vince at HBI that actually say that?
Objection. Calls for hearsay.
No.
Sustained.
No, because I've served you those letters. I've served
it's
those
still
letters.
Hearsay, and it's been sustained.
Are you aware of treatment from Dr. Habibi or any letters from Dr. Habibi?
Like I said in the pediatrics office, I don't know who Dr. Habibi is.
So you don't even know the doctors that are seeing your own sons?
I know the nurse practitioner that I take them to, but I've only taken them probably 3-4 times in the last 3 years. Because our children are hardly ever sick.
Do you remember ever asking for do you remember serving me or mailing paperwork to me at Graphic Center at the Graphic Center drive address at Siegel Suites?
What document are you talking about?
Do you remember sending paperwork, service paperwork to me, a binder to me, a legal binder to me at Siegel Suites?
The one you said you didn't receive? Yes.
Oh, so you remember getting, you remember sending?
Yes, but you said in open court that day of the trial that you never received the trial exhibit.
I didn't receive until afterwards, by the way, but I shouldn't be testifying. How did you receive that address? If you didn't know where I was.
You said it in court, and I wrote it down.
Do you know where I grew up?
In Malibu, California.
Do you know if I surfed?
Yes.
Do you know if I'm an avid scuba diver?
No.
I am.
Sir, you're testifying strike.
Oh, sorry about that.
That one's stricken.
Thank you.
Oh. some point in time, my staff is entitled to have a lunch break.
Let's take it.
So are we doing it now, or are we doing it in 10 minutes?
You can do it right now.
What?
You can do it right now.
Okay. Let's go off the record.
Well, Your Honor, while we're on the record, I have heard from the attorney of Dr. Collada. He can be available anytime after 2 o'clock today.
Perfect. We will come back at 1:30.
You want to leave this binder here, Your Honor?
What?
You want to leave this binder here?
That's actually my problem.